Hi, this is AJ. Welcome to the Point of View mini stories for excitement. Let's get started. Since last year, Brad has needed money for school. He has been very poor since last year. He lost all his money last year. So since last year, he has needed money for school. Of course, he has had a worthwhile purpose for needing money. He's had a worthwhile reason for needing money during this whole time, from last year up until recently. So Brad has needed money for school since last year, and since last year, he has had a worthwhile purpose. And during this time, he has thought about money every day. He has tried to find a way to get more money. But he has failed. Since last year, up until recently, he has failed to get more money. So he has not been able to go to school. Well, one day he got a great idea. He got a gun and he went to a convenience store. He went into the store. He pointed the gun at the clerk and he said, "Give me some money." And the clerk said, "Now, that's a very imprecise request. How about some specificity? Don't be ambiguous. Tell me exactly how much you want." Well, Brad was surprised, and he was silent for a while. And then finally he said, "I don't know. Bear with me while I think." Well, then Brad was silent again. He stood with the gun, thinking for a long, long time, thinking about the clerk's question, the clerk's request. He thought for 17 and a half hours. And then finally, after 17 and a half hours, Brad asked for $7,298 precisely. And because Brad's request was precise, the clerk gave it to him. The clerk gave him exactly $7,298. Brad ran home. Then he ran to school with the money. He paid for school. And he started to study again. Of course, Brad was very, very happy. What a happy story. Okay, next, same story. This time from a future point of view. This time using a future time frame. Let's go to the future, shall we? In the future, there will be a student named Brad. And Brad's gonna need money for school. He'll be a poor student, and he won't have money for school. Brad's gonna think about this problem a lot. Now, of course, he'll have a worthwhile purpose. It's a worthwhile purpose to need money for school. So he's gonna have a worthwhile purpose. And finally, he's gonna think of an idea. "Aha! I know how to get money," he'll think. He'll grab a gun, and he'll go to a convenience store. He'll go into the convenience store with his gun. He'll point his gun at the clerk, and he's gonna say exactly this: "Give me some money!" The clerk will be calm. He won't be scared. And the clerk will say, That's a very imprecise request. How about some specificity? Don't be ambiguous. Tell me exactly how much you want. Well, this is gonna confuse Brad and surprise him. He'll be silent for a while. And then finally he'll say, I don't know. Bear with me while I think. Then Brad will think. He'll think, and he'll think, and he'll think. He'll think for a very, very long time. In fact, he's going to think for 17 and a half hours, standing in the convenience store, pointing his gun at the clerk. Finally, after 17 and a half hours, he'll ask the clerk for precisely $7,298. And the clerk will be happy. Ah, great. That's a precise request. The clerk will give him the money. The clerk will give him exactly $7,298. Brad will take the money. He'll run home, and then he'll run to school. He'll pay for his school. He will begin to study again, and he will be very, very happy. And that's the end of the point of view story. Stories for excitement. I will see you next time. Bye-bye.